Hi guys, good to see you again in January 2022. 2021 is over. What a roller coaster year was 2021 for many of buyers. It was very strong seller's market, but this year finally over, and we're gonna be wrapping up in this episode last month, December 2021, because that are available for Seattle and East Side locations. And we're gonna talk about what's going to be happening in 2022, as 2022 have a lot of promises for buyers. But before we jump into this episode, I wanna say big thank you for all those 32 families who was able to use my services in 2021 to sell or buy home. Thank you so much, guys. Your interest will be always on top of my mind. And without you guys, I would be not in this place right now. Thank you. And let's start first episode in 2022. And I will start this episode with sales East Side. As you guys can see with me on the screen right now, we have 0.2 months of inventory with only guess how many homes available in Seattle's East Side in six cities like Mercer Island, Kirkland, Redmond, Woodinville, Issaquah, Bellevue, and Sammamish. How many homes for sale right now was in December 2021 and in January beginning of 2022? We had only 55 homes available on the market, and with 243 homes pending sales in this location. As you can see with me on the screen, in 2021 we have such low inventory. We pretty much have twice less inventory than we have a year ago, and we have probably 70% less inventory from 2019 and like 90% less inventory from 2018. This graph is dramatically dropped, as you guys can see, and this is why very difficult to find house right now for many buyers, because basically we don't have any inventory, we don't have many people who wants to sell the property in Seattle's East Side. And with that, guys, we have medium sell price $1,529,000 with 37% increase year over year in Seattle's East Side. And if you guys can see like data for couple like last 10 years what's happening, you guys can see last year in same time, specifically same time in December, prices increased about 17%, prices increased in 2019 for about 4%, and decreased in 2018. That's interesting, right? So when pandemic hit the market, the prices went up a lot, and people appreciate to buy real estate properties, appreciate to invest in real estate. The prices went off the roofs in last 3 years. On this slide, you guys can see the 75% homes selling above asking price, 6% at asking price, and only 8% sell below asking price. So 75% is a very big number for Seattle East Side. So pretty much with that, guys, chances of selling the property is really high as well. And they also sell in less than 15 days on the market. And as of selling is 92%. And if you guys can see, for last 10 years, odds of selling in Seattle East Side was very high. That market actually really healthy, really good for many sellers. And that market did not really change much for last decade. And also, I want to show you guys graph a number of listings sold above list price. And you guys can see, so that graph is changing in December. It's going up actually in December to 75% unprecedented level. And previous years, like in 2020, we have less homes sell above asking price. 2019 was flat year. 2018 was less homes as well. But in 2021, I think because we don't have any inventory, that's why we have those bidding wars right now. And anything on this side selling about between 25 to 35% above asking price. So that's what's happening in Seattle's East Side. And to wrap up Seattle's East Side with today's medium sell price, $1,529,500 translate this percentage to the dollars. You guys can see with me on the screen right now from November 2021, within 1 month, prices increased in Seattle's East Side for about 7%, and that's equal to $101,500 in 1 month. month. And if you compare what's happened in the last quarter from September 2021 till end of December 2021, we have prices increased for about 17%, and that's equal to $219,500. And if you compare what's happening for the year, if you translate those 37% price increase year over year, $415,735. Now let's check together data of what's happening in sales area from South Seattle, West Seattle to North Seattle and Magnolia, Queen Anne, Green Lake, all those locations as well. So you guys can see with me on the screen right now, we have 0.4 months of inventory and about 167 homes was on the market in December 2021 with 443 pending sales in those locations. Minimum sell price $839,000. An increase for 5% year over year. Inventory also dramatically decreased in Seattle areas from 586 homes available on the market a year ago to 167 homes at the same exactly time. So you guys can see Eastside and Seattle have very similar data with reduction of available listings, active listings in the market, which creates very strong sellers market and opportunity for many sellers to get top dollars if they planning to sell the property. 38% of all homes in Seattle selling above asking price, with 24% selling at asking price. If you compare what's happening on east from Lake Washington, it's a little bit different stories there. Much more hotter market than I see in Seattle locations. Seattle, I think, is more calm market and very similar to last month. You guys can see with me on the screen right now and very similar to last year. That's why we have only 5% price increase year over year. But also 65% of all homes in Seattle selling less than 15 days on the market also. And odds of selling very high, about 97%. And odds of selling in Seattle, if you guys look for whole decade, for last 10 years, was pretty high too. The lowest number I can see was in 2018, was about 72%. But pretty much anyone who planning to sell property in Seattle that was able to sell the property fairly quickly. Data for Seattle a little bit surprised me this time, because if we have only 5% increase year over year, it's we have pretty flat market in Seattle. Surprisingly, we have a lot of inventory, a lot of homes coming on the market in Seattle, and with high demand on today's market, that makes market pretty flat. That's why we don't see that huge increase in Seattle. But again, people who looking to buy property in Seattle was able to find those homes, and they have more choices, more easy market. And I think Seattle is changing right now, and I think Seattle have a lot of possibilities and a lot of opportunities in 2022 for affordable housing market in Seattle locations. Number of listings sold above list price in Seattle area is decreasing right now. And you guys can see this graph with me on the screen. Its demand is decreasing, very similar to what's happening in 2017. For example, 2020, demand was increasing this time of the year, but in 2021, actually demand is decreasing. So in the end, what I'm thinking, like if we're going to have more inventory in Seattle in a spring market, homes become more affordable, our price is going to be stay steady probably for a couple of the months, and buyers are going to have more chances, more opportunity to choose homes they like, and they're going to be buy those homes. But peak of the market, I think, for Seattle was October 2021. And as of October 2021, each month demand for housing market in Seattle actually decreasing. And now it becomes very interesting. A lot of people ask me questions, what I'm thinking about real estate market, what's going to be happen in 2022. And market is actually jumping all over the places. Every time Federal Reserve announced some news or some articles, you guys see with me what's happening in January 5th, the stock market crash after announced this article about inflation and about what's going to be happen. The published article, this one, I put it on the screen for you guys. but an initial tweet at about 14 pages is very interesting information there. They worry about inflation, they worry about tapering inflation, what they're going to do to taper inflation, but a lot of positive news, like economy is doing good right now, and right now it's a good time for doing those changes and pull those like available cash from the market and stopped buying mortgage-backed securities and government loans. So we're gonna see less money in the market, and with that, guys, inflation's gonna be hit a little bit harder probably right now. Will be interesting to see in January 12th CPI report what will be inflation rate, and last month's inflation was like 6.2%, and the expected inflation for January about 7.1%. If inflation is going to be announced more than 8%, like let's say 8.5 or 9%, stock market and market actually going to be reacting on that. So that's going to be a lot of changes, a lot of shifts in the market, and we'll see what's going to be happen. But stock market is very tight with real estate market, because if people sell off stocks and just move those money, the very safe location to move money is a real estate, and a lot of homes selling right now in Seattle East in Seattle, it's a cash buyer buying pretty much 30% of all homes on Seattle East Side at this moment. And a lot of shifting of the money, I see it on the market right now. But again, I think 2022 will be different market from 2021. And we're not going to see that crazy year-over-year appreciation like we saw from 30 to 37%. But we're going to see less appreciation, probably between 6% to 10, 12% in 2022. It's still going to be, I think, by end of 2022, seller's market, but not as strong as 2021. But for buyers, will be big relief, specifically if interest rate going to be increased, because if increased interest rate, buyer's power going to be decreased, and a lot of sellers who on edge right now to sell property or not to sell property, they are waiting for the best time to cash out, to sell this home and get most possible money for the properties. And who's selling properties right now? Baby boomers, people who retiring or planning to retire or retired already. They're moving out of states, they're moving to islands, and they're moving to different locations where more affordable, and those people going to be sell those property will be big relief for the buyers. And I believe we're going to have a lot of listings coming up in February, March, April. Gonna be big relief, gonna be a lot of homes for sale, and specifically probably in March and April, because March and April, that's what going to be announced, increased rates, and increasing rates going to be reflect increasing mortgage rates as well. But even right now, the rates not increased yet, but mortgage rates already increased because market already react for Feds, what Feds going to do in the future next couple of months, and market actually adjusting and market making own reaction to those news and those information. But that, guys, I hope this episode was helpful for you guys, helpful in 2022 to move forward, helpful for you guys if you're looking to buy a home or to sell a home. And if you guys need any help with real estate, I will be glad to help you as well. Like I helped those 32 families in 2021, I will be glad to help you in 2022. You guys can see my number on the screen, reach out to me. I will be love to be your real estate resource. I will be love to give you my advice to a specific location, to a specific neighborhood where you live in. I will be glad to be your real estate resource. Stay tuned, make a fantastic week, until next market update in February 2022.